Children, today we are going to complete chapter 4, The Rat Trap, from your Flamingo book. Now you will come to know when Adela brought the poor paddler to their house. As her father was thinking this man to be his old comrade friend. But the girl now wanted to clear her doubts about this man. So let's see, what are the doubts of this girl? It is clear that things have gone downhill with him as badly as that, said daughter. Last night, I didn't think there was anything about him to show that he had once been an educated man. Quiver means strange. Downhill means to get worsened or deteriorated of the situation. Here, the girl asks the father, it seemed to be quite strange how things could get deteriorated with some person this way. She said she was really doubtful when she met the man last night, as there was found nothing about him to be the educated one. You must have patience, my little girl, said the father. As soon as he gets clean and dressed up, you will see something different. Father tried to clarify her doubts. All his looks were different due to his embarrassment at night. He said all the trim manners of this man would fall away from him the moment he would shed his trim clothes. Definitely, he would give decent look when his clothes would be changed. Just as he said this, the door opened and the stranger entered. Yes, now he was truly clean and well-dressed. The valet had bathed him, cut his hair and shaved him. Moreover, he was dressed in a good-looking suit of clothes which belonged to the iron master. He wore a white shirt and a starched collar and whole shoes. Starched collar? Starch is the stuff that make your shirt collar look crispy and fresh. Right now, both his father and daughter were discussing about the stranger. He made the entry into the room with the valet. He was looking good and well clean, as the valet had given him bath, cut his hair and shaved his beard. Right now, he was wearing the iron master's good looking clothes and shoes. His white shirt had a starched collar and shoes were covering his entire feet. He was looking quite different right now. But although his guest was now well groomed, the iron master did not seem pleased. He looked at him with puckered brow. Puckered brow, that means wrinkled forehead. Right now, when this guest was well dressed and brought before the iron master, he was not happy to see his appearance. He looked at him with the wrinkled forehead. That means he got worried to see the strange look of the stranger. It was easy to understand that when he had seen the strange fellow in the uncertain reflection from the furnace, he might have made a mistake. He understood that he had mistaken the stranger to be his old friend, as he had seen the appearance of this man in the dim light of the furnace. But that now, when he stood there in broad daylight, it was impossible to mistake him for an old acquaintance. Acquaintance means friendship. What does this mean? He thundered. Thundered means to shout loudly. Right now, when the iron master saw the stranger in the broad sunlight, he could easily make out that he was not his old friend. He shouted at the man with the words, what does this mean? Why, you are looking different. The stranger made no attempt to dissimulate. Dissimulate means to hide the feelings. But this poor stranger did not try to hide his feelings. He saw at once that the splendor had come to an end. He understood instantly the time of all the favors and hospitality of this family is over now. It's not my fault, sir, he said. I never pretended to be anything but a poor trader. and I pleaded and begged to be allowed to stay in the forge. But no harm has been done. At worst, I can put on my rags again and go away. The paddler tried to explain that he should not be blamed. It was not his fault. He said, I never behaved to be anything else but only to be the poor businessman selling the rat trap. He said he only wanted the night stay in the forge, but still no harm has been done. He was ready to put on his old rags and leave the place. Well, said the Iron Master, hesitating a little. It was not quite honest either, you must admit that, and I should not be surprised if the sheriff would like to have something to say in the matter. Sheriffs are the principal law enforcement officers of the counties. Right now, to find his own mistake. The Iron Master, embarrassed, he hesitated, but he gave a threat to the paddler that he had to be honest, and either he had to admit his mistake, otherwise he was going to call the sheriff for his arrest. The tramp took a step forward and struck the table with his fist. Now I'm going to tell you, Mr. Iron Master, how things are, he said. This whole world is nothing but a big rat trap. All the good things that are offered to you are nothing but cheese rinds and bits of pork set out to drag a poor fellow into the trouble. To get the threat about the sheriff, the rat trap seller became angry and enraged. He instantly struck the table hard with his fist. He explained to the Iron Master it was not at all his fault. He said he would explain him how the matter is. He said this whole world is nothing but a big rat trap, and all the things are here provided, just like the rinds of cheese and the small pieces of pork are provided to the rats. He said that this whole world is nothing but a big rat trap, just like we set the bait of cheese rinds and bits of pork for the rats to trap inside the rat trap. Similarly, the world also offered us the good things to be entrapped in the rat trap of the world. So same was the reason he was dragged and pulled into the trouble. Now he pointed out to the Iron Master that if the sheriff would come to arrest him that day. The Iron Master began to laugh. That was not so badly said, my good fellow. Perhaps we should let the sheriff alone on Christmas Eve. But now get out of here as fast as you can. Though the Iron Master didn't like his words, but he was amused. So he decided not to call the sheriff. He said he would invite him only for the celebration on the Christmas Eve. But he gave the warning to the peddler to leave immediately his home. But just as the man was opening the door, the daughter said, I think he ought to stay with us today. I don't want him to go. When the man was leaving the house and just opening the door, the Iron Master's daughter went and stopped him by saying it was their duty to help this poor fellow. So she won't let this man to go. By saying this, she went and closed the door. What in the world are you doing? Said the father. The daughter stood there quite embarrassed and hardly knew what to answer. To get the scolding from the father for her initiative, the daughter was puzzled and embarrassed and had no words to reply. That morning she had felt so happy when she thought how homelike and Christmassy she was going to make things for the poor hungry wretch. She could not get away from the idea all at once, and that was why she had interceded for the vagabond. Wretch here means miserable person. Interceded means intervened or spoke on behalf of somebody else. She replied that since morning she was quite pleased and happy to prepare something for feeding the poor miserable man on this great occasion of Christmas. And she was feeling homelike and Christmassy, and she didn't want to get away from this feeling all at once. That's why she was here interceding this wanderer side and stopping him at their home. "I'm thinking of the stranger here," said the young girl. "He walks and walks the whole year long, and there is probably not a single place in the whole country where he is welcome and can feel at home." "Feel at home means to feel comfortable," the girl tried to explain the difficulties faced by the stranger. She said that the whole year long he would be walking, and there would be not a single place in the whole country where he is ever welcomed or feel comfortable, as he has no home. Wherever he turns, he is chased away, and always he is afraid of being arrested and cross-examined. She said he was always kept on running in order to safeguard himself from being arrested. So she desired that she wanted him to enjoy a day of peace and comfort with them, with their family, just one in the whole year. The iron master mumbled something in his beard. He could not bring himself to oppose her. It was all a mistake, of course, she continued. "But anyway, I don't think we ought to chase away a human being whom we have asked to come here and to whom we have promised Christmas cheer." Mumbled means to mutter something in low sound. The iron master tried to oppose the girl, but he did not have any words. The girl said, though it was their mistake to invite the wrong person, but they should not chase away or insult the human being whom they had invited themselves to stay with them and promise the Christmas cheer. It would be the big insult to the humanity. "You do preach worse than a parson," said the iron master. "I only hope you won't have to regret this." The young girl took the stranger by the hand and led him up to the table. "Now sit down and eat," she said, for she could see that her father had given in. Preach means to persuade others by giving speech. Parson means churchman or priest. As the iron master had already surrendered before the girl, he only said that the girl had more convincing power than the priest of the church. But he only warned her that her decision should not bring any harm to her. After hearing his words, Adela understood her father had given up. So she took the peddler from his hand to the dining table and ordered him to sit and enjoy the food. Intercede means to intervene or spoke on behalf of somebody else. Now the peddler did not say any word and started eating on the dining table. Though he was doubtful about the intention of this girl and was still wondering what could be the idea behind helping him and stopping him in their house. The man with red tufts said not a word. He only sat down and helped himself to the food. Time after time, he looked at the young girl who had interceded for him. Why had she done it? What could the crazy idea be? After that morning incident, the Christmas Eve was celebrated just like it used to be in Ramzo. The stranger did not harm the family because he did nothing there but only sleep. The whole afternoon he lay on the sofa in the guest room and slept at one stretch. In the afternoon they had to wake him up to take his meal of the Christmas fair. But after that, very surprisingly, he slept again. It was seeming that this man was not able to sleep so soundly and comfortably anywhere, just like he was sleeping there in the Ramzo. After that, Christmas Eve at Ramzo passed just as it always had. The stranger did not cause any trouble because he did nothing but sleep. The whole forenoon he lay on the sofa in one of the guest rooms and slept at one stretch. At noon, they woke him up so that he could have his share of the good Christmas fear. But after that, he slept again. It seemed as though for many years he had not been able to sleep as quietly and safely as here at Ramzo. In the evening, when the Christmas tree was lighted, they woke him up again and stood for a while in the drawing room, blinking as though the candlelight hurt him. But after that, he disappeared again. 2 hours later, he was aroused once more. He then had to go down into the dining room and eat the Christmas fish and porridge. Blinking means to open and shut the eyelids. In the evening, when the family woke him up as they were going to light up the Christmas tree, he stood and attended the ceremony, but his eyes were blinking and getting hurt by the bright light of the candles. But after the ceremony, he again went to sleep. Finally, they had to call him to have the dinner of Christmas fish and porridge in the dining room. As soon as they got up from the table, he went around to each one present and said thank you and good night. But when he came to the young girl, she gave him to understand that it was her father's intention that the suit which he wore was to be a Christmas present. He didn't have to return it, and if he wanted to spend next Christmas Eve in a place where he could rest in peace and be sure that no evil would befall him, he would be welcomed back again. After taking the dinner, the butler went to everyone to thank for their good services and wished good night. And then he reached near the girl, and the girl made him understand that the suit which he was wearing, it was gifted now to him as a Christmas present from her father's side, so he could carry with him. She even invited the peddler that if he wanted to spend the next Christmas Eve with them, he has to give assurance that he would never follow any wrong way in his life. With this condition to be good in life, he would be welcome back again in the next Christmas Eve to stay peacefully with the family. The man with the red tufts didn't answer anything to this. He only stared at the young girl in boundless amazement. Boundless means limitless. Amazement means wonder or surprise. Now the man with the red tuft, he was not ready to get this more surprise and favor from this girl for some stranger. He started now gazing at the girl with limitless surprise and wonder. The next morning, the ironmaster and his daughter got up in good season to go to the early Christmas service. The guest was still asleep and they didn't disturb him. As the next day was the Christmas day, now the family woke up early in the morning in the good mood to pay the Christmas service. But they didn't disturb their guest as he was still sleeping. When at about 10 o'clock they drove back from the church, the young girl sat and hung her head even more dejectedly than usual. At church, she had learned that one of the old crofters of the ironworks had been robbed by a man who went around selling rat traps. It was about 10 o'clock when both the father and the daughter were returning back home from the church. The young girl was sitting in the carriage, hanging her head down with more dejection and sadness than usual, as at church she had learned that some crofter of the ironwork had been robbed by a man with the red traps. "Yes, that was a fine fellow you let into the house," said the father. "I only wonder
How many silver spoons are left in the cupboard? By this time, the father started scolding the girl by saying it was his daughter who let this thief to stay and take shelter in the house. He wondered and suspected that the thief would have certainly stolen many silver spoons from the house in their absence now.
The wagon had hardly stopped at the front steps when the ironmaster asked the valet whether the stranger was still there. He added that he had heard at church that the man was a thief. His carriage had hardly reached near the front steps of his home. The ironmaster shouted for his valet to inquire whether the stranger was still there at home. He informed that he had heard from the church that man was a thief. The valet answered that the fellow had gone and that he had not taken anything with him at all. On the contrary, he had left behind a little package which Miss Wilmanson was to be kind enough to accept as a Christmas gift. To the very surprise of the ironmaster, the attendant informed the person had gone, but he had not taken anything or stolen anything with him. But to his very surprise, he had left a small gift which his daughter had to accept as a Christmas present. The wagon had hardly stopped at the front steps when the ironmaster asked the valet whether the stranger was still there. He added that he had heard at church that the man was a thief. His carriage had hardly reached near the front steps of his home. The ironmaster shouted for his valet to inquire whether the stranger was still there at home. He informed that he had heard from the church that man was a thief. The valet answered that the fellow had gone and that he had not taken anything with him at all. On the contrary, he had left behind a little package which Miss Wilmanson was to be kind enough to accept as a Christmas gift. To the very surprise of the ironmaster, the attendant informed the person had gone. Instead of taking anything, he had left a small package for Miss Wilmanson as a Christmas gift. It was quite surprising that the peddler had left a gift for Adela, the ironmaster's daughter. The young girl opened the package, which was so badly done up that the contents came into the view at once. She gave a little cry of joy. She found a small rat trap, and in it lay three wrinkled tantronaut notes. But that was not all. In the rat trap lay also a letter written in large Jack characters. Package means parcel. Jack characters, these are the uneven letters written in his note. When the girl opened the parcel given by the peddler, she understood even from outside the package what could be the content, as it was badly wrapped by that poor man. When she opened the package, she shouted with excitement to see the content inside. There she found a small rat trap along with lying there three wrinkled 10-kronor currency notes. Beside this surprise, she also found in the rat trap a letter addressed to her, written by the poor peddler in his big uneven handwriting. "Honored and noble miss, since you have been so nice to me all day long, as if I was a captain, I want to be nice to you in return, as if I was a real captain, for I don't want you to be embarrassed at this Christmas season by a thief. But you can give back the money to the old man on the roadside, who's a money pouch hanging on the window frame, as a bait for poor wanderers. The rat trap is a Christmas present from a rat who would have been caught in this world's rat trap if he had not been raised to captain, because in that way he got power to clear himself. Written with friendship and high regard, Captain von Stirling." In this letter, which was addressed to Adela. It was given the note by the peddler that, first of all, he wanted to oblige and thank this girl for treating him with such dignity and respect the whole day long, as he had really been captain of the army. He does not want to get embarrassed, this girl, with the information that she has had some thief. Once, he made confession that it is the goodness of the girl that has transformed and cleansed his soul, and that's why he is returning back the stolen money, and the money should be returned back to the old crofter who lived near the roadside, but who used to hang his money loose in the leather pouch on the window frame, so that the poor wanderers like him, they should be attracted by the money and be trapped in the rat trap of the world. He is also mentioned in the letter that this rat trap is a small Christmas gift from a rat who would not have been able to escape from the worst rat trap if he had not been raised to the status of a captain by this kind girl. That's why his dignity had been restored. This is the reason he had signed himself at the end with the name Captain Von Staley. Indeed, he wants to leave the impression on that kind-hearted girl that he has transformed so long. That's why he signed himself with the name Captain Von Staley. The story has exemplified the truth that there is innate goodness in every human being, and it's always the need of a little love, understanding and a gesture of friendship which could take it out. So here it is done by this kind-hearted girl, Adela. Thank you everyone for watching the video. To get the latest updates of the course, do like, share, comment and subscribe the channel.